world to die for our sins, that we might believe on him and learn how to trust in the Lord. When you look through the Old Testament, you can see some of the old saints that trusted in God. You look back over our life and look back over the Old Testament. That word "fret not" is used more than 25 times. They learned how to be uneasy. They learned how to stay out of a state of anxiety. Why? Because they put their trust in the Lord. And we have to learn, even in 2019, we got to learn how to fret not because of evildoers. We can't go around worrying about other folk. We can't worry about our haters, because all that God wants us to do is to make sure that we continue to commit our ways unto him. He wants us to realize that not only we have to commit our ways unto him, but we also have to find delight in the Lord. David said, "I'd rather be a doorkeeper in the house of the Lord than to dwell in the seat of sinners." He says, "Behold, you need to learn how to walk not in the counsel of the ungodly, nor sit it in the seat of sinners, nor walk it in the way of the scornful. But his delight is in the law of the Lord. In it doth he meditate both day and night. He shall be like a tree planted by the rivers of water. In due season it will bring forth fruit." God is telling you this morning, in due season he's going to bring forth some fruit in your life if you learn not to go around worrying about things that you can't control. That's why he told David, he said, "Fret not, David, even though you have some evildoers that want to do you some harm, you don't have to worry. David, I was always there. I've been with you from the time that you came in. I'll be with you until the time that you go out." How do we put our trust in God? How do we commit our ways unto the Lord? How do we delight in the Lord? First thing that we have to do, we have to believe that God, in his infinite wisdom, sent his son Jesus to die on an old rugged cross. Yeah. He died for you. He died for me. In that while we were yet sinners, Christ came and died for the ungodly. If you want God to have your back, you got to realize, you got to put your trust in his son Jesus Christ, the one that died on the cross, the one that hung there from the sixth hour to the ninth hour. He hung right there for your sins and mine. He did not come down from the cross. He decided to just stay right there for your sins and my sins.
Yes.
So as we look into this text, what I want you to carry with you today, I want you to carry with you and take with you the first two words: fret not. Fret not. Don't worry about things that's out of your control. Things happen in this life. Sometimes unexpectedly, things happen. You don't know sometimes what life or tomorrow will bring. Mm-hmm. But we do know one thing, because we are all believers, and we know that the Lord Jesus Christ have had our back ever since we've been in this world. Sometimes we look back and we begin to get a little anxious because we're wondering, man, I wonder if he still got my back. I wonder if I should still do this. But don't worry, God has still got your back.